Hey everybody, it's Alan, and I hope that you are doing well. Today is August 2nd, and on this date back in 1983, bass playing legend James Jamerson passed away. Now, you might wonder, why am I going to listen to a Robert Palmer song? Well, this is kind of an interesting one because James Jamerson didn't always play for Motown. He actually had left Motown and did a number of sessions afterward, and one of those sessions was for Robert Palmer. And in this particular song called Trouble, you not only have Robert Palmer, legendary singer that we love on this channel, not only have James Jamerson, bass player who we love on this channel, but you also have a song written and performed with Lowell George of Little Feet, who we also love on this channel. So with that said, we're going to celebrate the memory of the great James Jamerson by listening to him play with Lowell George and Robert Palmer on the song Trouble. Now, here's a question. How do you think that conversation went? Or how do you think that, you know, meeting of the minds went? You know, do you think Robert Palmer went to a Little Feet concert and saw them playing live and got backstage and hooked up with Lowell George and said, "Man, I love your sound. I wish I could have a song like that on my new project that I'm working on." And Lowell George, "Well, you know, we could probably figure out something." And then Robert Palmer goes, "Yeah, you know, I got a killer session band going. I got James Jamerson on bass and all these other great musicians, man." And do you think Lowell George was like, "Oh, man, it's Jamerson playing with Jamerson? Oh, man, that's a dream come true. I'd love to play with Jamerson. So let's write this song and here's Trouble and blah, blah, blah." Or do you think it was completely different? Do you think Lowell George went and saw Robert Palmer play and was like, "Man, what a voice. Man, I got this song that would be perfect for that voice." And then he approached, you know, Robert and was like, "Hey, you know, your sound is incredible. I got this perfect song for your voice for this. And it's obviously got a little bit of Little Feat vibe to it, but man, if we had the right musicians. And then Robert's like, well, I got a session book with Jamerson. So, you know, we got a bass player who can really, really play that groove. And I mean, I'm just wondering what it would be like to be a fly on the wall with that sort of that session. You know, what would it be like to be in that room and listen to those great musicians and that amazing voice performing together and working out parts and getting things happening? It must have been, I mean, I imagine it must have been incredible. I would have loved to have heard that. I would have loved to have heard studio outtakes or just conversations happening on tape that you know, are now, you know, lost to time in many ways. Yeah. Anyway, fun way to remember the late, great James Jamerson and that amazing bass playing on a song that you probably wouldn't have expected me to play as a celebration for the late, great James Jamerson. Anyway, with that said, hope you enjoyed this bit of a deeper track down the James Jamerson, Robert Palmer, Lowell George road. Please feel free to leave a comment in the comment section below. We can talk about it further. Just know that I appreciate all of you, and I wish you well. Take care.